teach your children well. Their father's hell did slowly go by.
Every kid wants a cool parent, but not the parent that's hip with the latest styles. The kind of parent that keeps their cool in every situation. Does that describe?
Not so much.
Every situation, absolutely not. Well, maybe you need this new book. It is called Scream Free Parenting. It's by Hal Runkel, and he is joining us today. How are you?
Hey, I'm doing great.
I love this because you said it's for parents of 6-year-olds and 16-year-olds.
It's for parents of all ages with kids of all ages because, as you guys know, parenting is the hardest thing that most of us have been called to. It's just continually challenging us. And it's not just asking our kids to grow up. It's about asking us to grow up, no matter how old our kids are. And that's the first point about the book, is that parenting's not about kids. It's about parents.
It's about the parents and exactly. Changing your behavior.
Exactly.
As a parent. I've read a lot of this book, which I really, really relate with. One of the things in the book you address is what should a parent do when a child is out of control? Because
right.
I find myself raising my voice, yelling,
of course.
You know,
of course.
Grabbing him to put him in timeout.
Because nobody can push your buttons like your kid.
Of course. Right. And a 2-year-old really, and I've been told 3-year-olds as well, will
well,
do
that's
it
their
too.
Job.
So what do you do as a parent? How do you get yourself under control?
Scream-free parenting is not about finding some magical technique to control your kids so that they never get to that point and push your buttons. It's about ultimately just creating a pause between stimulus, your kids pushing your buttons or driving you crazy, and response. Because what happens is we get reactive. And whenever we
yes.
get emotionally reactive, we don't just make things worse, we actually create the very outcome we were hoping to avoid. I tell a story in the second chapter of the book about my son climbing up the stairs on the outside of the banister, you know, just hanging onto the pickets. He's 2 years old.
Sounds like
he's,
my guy.
Yeah, 5 feet off the ground. His feet are 5 feet off the ground. Okay, what the heck do you do now? Now, I wasn't planning on going downstairs, so I could have just ignored the situation, kept on trucking down the hall. I hear all the time, I'm not a screaming parent, I'm a laid-back parent. Well, that's just another form of screaming, because what you're doing is disconnecting from the situation and saying, hoping it works out. And usually the laid-back parent is married to a screamer who's having to make up for your laid-backness. Did I just describe your relationship? But my integrity demands that I address the situation. My son's in mortal danger. But what happens if I stay connected in that situation but give in to my panic? What happens if I yell? What happens if I
He's going to panic and
exactly.
he's going to drop, isn't he?
Exactly.
Yeah.
And it's the same situation. Let's say I've been telling my daughter, you can tell me anything. You can tell me anything. Well, she's 16. She comes to me and says, Dad, I want to have sex with my boyfriend. What? Oh, my gosh. I can't handle it. How can you say that to me? Well, what's his name? We're never going to let you out of the house. What have I just
Where's
done?
Where's my shotgun?
Exactly.
Right.
Not only is she not going to come to me anymore, but I've just created Romeo and Juliet. She's now going to run to that guy or some other guy.
So how do you act calm in one of those situations? Because if Natalie was climbing up the outside of the stairs,
right.
it would take me more than a second to not scream.
See, I have to first, and that's what the book I hope does, is inspire people to take themselves and their own emotional reactivity seriously. So that when I'm on the stairs, my focus is not on her, my
okay.
focus is on me, because I know I can just mess this up. So what did I do with my son on the stairs? I closed my eyes. Because I knew as long as I was looking at him in danger, I wouldn't be able to react calmly, so I closed my eyes.
And
get a pause. Mm-hmm. And then I began to walk downstairs, and then I walked behind him, pulled him down, and shook him. You know.
Right, of course.
I read something in here that it took me aback just
okay.
a little bit, but
Go
I want
ahead.
You to describe it.
Uh-huh.
Kids should not be the most important thing in your life.
Absolutely.
When I think about my life, my little boy is it.
I know.
He shouldn't be.
Well, think of the message that we send to our kids. Don't you know you mean the whole world to me? Like, yikes. You know, I'm in my 30s. I'm not equipped to be anybody's whole world, but certainly not when I was 5 or 15.
Ooh. So you're saying it puts a lot of responsibility.
Of course. You better not mess up. You better behave in the grocery store. You better respect me and appreciate all the sacrifices I make for you.
Oh, that's interesting.
Instead, realizing, you know what? What kids need most are parents who do not need them. I don't need you to behave. I don't need you to obey me. I'm still going to behave how I want to behave, regardless of how you behave.
I love that.
So
I've never thought of it that way.
I don't need you to validate me or make me feel loved or whatever. There's none of that pressure on you. You're just going to be a kid, and you're going to make mistakes, and I'm going to give you consequences for those mistakes. But I'm not going to ask you to be the most important thing in my life.
On page Ooh. 3, you said, this may be the first book that you've read that tells all parents to stop orbiting their lives around your children and return the focus to yourself.
I cannot orbit my life around my kids without giving them the distinct impression that the world revolves around them.
Hmm.
And I have the nerve to call them self-centered. But I helped create that by putting many stickers all over my minivans with my kids' names on it, you know, shouting to the whole world who really owns the van. But mothers especially have believed this lie that, you know what, once you become a mom, that's who you are. You are mom, so you might as well just give up being a sexy, independent woman anymore. Just get the bob haircut, you know, and the denim overalls and the Keds and just say, that's who you are from now on, you know, that's your life.
You know what I love to howl about this book is there was a time you were talking about taking the emotion out of it and saying, say the daughter's late.
Sure.
I think it was Julia or something. Yeah. You said, I'm going to leave in 10 minutes. It is your choice
sure.
to come with me or not. Instead sure. of going, Julia, get in the car. I'm leaving.
Now, in that situation.
But you can use that for anyone.
Sure. Well, they live close. Well, my wife, I'm writing Scream for Marriage right now. And the first story is
about Oh, thank you. You're coming back. Yeah. Please come back.
Yeah. Exactly. It's not about what you do. It's about what I do. Because I'm only ultimately in control of me. Not in control of my kids.
But Hal, you're not going to really leave your three-year-old.
Right, exactly. So that story about a 16-year-old
enough. Julia was,
right.
was responsible
exactly.
and older. Yeah, because it talks about teenagers, too.
Exactly, it does. And one of the chapters is called Empty Threats Are Really Broken Promises. So yeah, don't put empty threats that you're not going to follow through with. Mm-hmm. But again, it's not about what you do, it's about what I do. So my daughter, you know, let's say she leaves her bike out in the grass, and we go, oh, you better bring it in, you better bring it in, instead of saying, honey, it's obvious you love your bike, that's great. You have a choice. You can bring it in, that's great. You can leave it out, that's your choice as well. But if you do, I'm taking it to Goodwill in the morning.
Ooh. And you really have to take it, that's the problem.
And I'm not angry at you, I'm going to respect the choice you make.
Okay, here's the name of the book again, everyone. Scream Free Parenting, it is by Hal Runkel, and you can get it at bookstores right now. I feel like I'm glad
it's
I have
be
my
I
think he brought this one too, I need
this
one.
And you can go to our website, screamfree.com, and download a free copy of the first chapter.
Hal, thank you so much.
Thanks, guys.
Appreciate that. All right, coming up next, tickets to Finding Nemo on Ice. We'll be right back.